In this video, we will show you how to sign up and log in Supabase users to a WeWeb app. In WeWeb, you will want to go to the Plugins tab, the Authentication category, and add the Supabase Auth plugin. If you have already added the Supabase Data Source plugin like we have here, the project URL and public API key will already be included, but you will need to add your private API key. You can find all three pieces of information in Supabase in the project settings, API, the project URL is here, the public API key is here, and you can reveal the secret key and paste it in your WeWeb project. So I cut my screen share for a few seconds and pasted my private API key in WeWeb. I cut my screen share because this key, as its name implies, needs to stay private. Okay, let's click continue. You will be invited to choose the page where users should be redirected when they're not signed into your app. So this could be a login page, it could be your home page. What's important is that the page should be public. If it's not public, then users who are not signed in will get caught in an infinite loop where they are trying to access a private page, but they don't have the rights because they're not authenticated and the app will crash. So make sure that the page is public. Here we'll choose the login page. For now, we don't need to define any role tables. We will focus on signing up and logging in users. Once you've added the Supabase Auth plugin, you will have access to the specific UI kit elements related to Supabase authentication. Let's use the login section in a login page. So let's go to the page. We have an empty login page and we can see it's public because there's this little globe icon. If it was private, it would have a little lock icon. So we want to make sure it is not private. All right, on my login page, I will drag and drop this login section. And it comes with a form container that has a workflow that calls the login with email Supabase action. When you add Supabase Auth, you will get access to new workflow actions like signing up, logging in, login with magic link, login with provider, log out. And then you can choose where to redirect users after they have logged in. For example, you could redirect them to their user profile. And here I see the little icon that tells me the user profile is public. So it's a good idea to go ahead and change that. Make sure that only authenticated users can access the user profile page. We'll add security in the backend for the content related to the user profile, but that is a topic for another video. Okay, so we have a login page. We might want a signup page as well. Sign up. Say that. And I like dashes. So let's add it to the auth folder and let's drag it, drop the signup section here. And here again, we have a signup workflow ready to go with the email input value and the password input. We could ask users for metadata. So in Supabase, if I go to the auth schema and look at my users table, I see there is a user metadata, which is a JSON object. And this is standard in Supabase. So in WeWeb, I can select from a dropdown if I want to ask for more information. For example, I could ask the user for a nickname. So in that case, in my form, I would add a nickname field. And here it I would change that input to nickname. So that way, when the user types in, for example, Joyce plus tutorial, web.io, so I'm going to sign up as a new user. I'm going to pretend my nickname is JK, and I'm going to choose a really silly password. I can see the inputs here. And then when I go to my form container, to my workflow, here I can see that the email value is correctly mapped to my email input. The password is correctly mapped to my password input. And here I can bind to my nickname input. And then I can choose to redirect users to the home page, for example, which is the cars page. Because when I sign up with Supabase, I will actually be logged in. So if I test this, let's see what happens here. If I test this, oh, I forgot to change the input type. So that's important. And this is why, by the way, the workflow should be on the form container. So you have this field validation. So let's go here again and sign up. Nothing is happening here, but if I look at my action, I see it's green. And if I go to Supabase in my users table in the auth schema, I can see that this new user was created. And for now, I haven't confirmed my email yet, but I can do that here. I will have received an email at joyce+tutorial@weweb.io, and I can confirm my email. And then I am redirected to the page that I set up. Here, my home page. And now in WeWeb, I am also authenticated. In order to improve the user experience so that the user knows that the signup process worked and they need to check their emails, we could add a little message here, so maybe a text, and add it here and say check your emails to confirm your signup. And then on the form container workflow, we could have a change variable where it would be display success message, and it would be a boolean, so true false. By default it would be false, and when the sign up is successful it would be true, so display success message true. And then this would only appear when the variable is true. So here it would be hidden because it's false. But then if we signed up again, it would change to true when the sign up action was successful. Now let's go back to our homepage. And on the logout button, we will simply create a logout action. And now when the user clicks on this, they will no longer be authenticated. And we can now create a login flow. So we could have a dedicated login page, or we could have a button that which we have here. And when we click on it, it displays a modal. And then inside that modal, we have a form container with a workflow on submit that logs us in with our email. And then we will map the email input inside the modal and the password input inside the modal also. And then we would change, when this is successful, we would change the variable modal open back to false. So now if I log in as Joyce plus tutorial at weweb.io, if I sign in here, I should again be authenticated and the modal was closed. Supabase provides us with this option to sign up and log in with email and password out of the box. However, there are a couple of limitations that you should be aware of that you will need to configure in your Supabase project to ensure that sign up and login functionality with email and password can scale with your app. So the first thing to look at in your project settings here in the auth category is you want to make sure that you've enabled new users to sign up. Depending on your project, perhaps you do not want new users to be able to sign up on their own. Maybe you want to make sure that you invite them. So you need to check by default, this setting is disabled in Supabase. So if you want users to be able to sign up, make sure to enable it. The second thing is that Supabase's built-in email service is rate limited and the limits are quite low. So as soon as you're going to want to publish your app and get in front of a real user base, you'll want to enable custom SMTP settings and fill out that information based on your SMTP provider. And make sure, of course, to save your changes. That's it. That's how you can allow users to authenticate with email and password using a Supabase backend and WeWeb frontend. If you want to allow users to authenticate with their Google or Slack account, for example, you can check out Supabase's list of authorized providers and check out our own video on how to authenticate with these providers using a Supabase backend and the WeWeb frontend.